Well, as we move into Christmas, we've done a bit of a tidy up for the year around the economy with the half year update. And what it shows is that the economy is growing a bit slower than we expected 6 or 8 months ago. But next year it will pick up, and that'll be helped a bit by the Rugby World Cup and by the Canterbury earthquake. But the most important issue we're going to be dealing with next year is national savings. We've talked before about how New Zealand's vulnerable to our overseas markets because we are borrowing so much money. We currently owe the world around about $170 billion, and over the next 4 or 5 years that's forecast to increase in proportion to our economy. So we're like a household or a business that's running overdrafts and putting that, adding that overdraft to the mortgage, and the bank managers who listen to people like the ratings agencies could start saying, well, that they don't want to keep financing that growing mortgage. So to get that vulnerability reduced and to reduce our overseas debt, we're going to be focusing on two things next year. One is trying to lock in the change in behaviour we've seen in New Zealand households. Most people are doing the same thing, being careful with their spending, trying to get their debt down, not taking risks. That is having an effect in the short term of keeping the economy a bit flatter, but in the long term it's the right change for New Zealand, and the question is whether we can lock that in. Now, the tax switch that we announced in the middle of the year will have some impact on that because it favours savings over consumption and debt. But we set up a savings working group around the time of the budget to give us some advice about any other steps that we can take to lock that in. The other thing we need to focus on is just government's contribution to increasing that overseas debt, because at the moment it's government that's driving it up, whereas households are being pretty careful. Today we announced an increase in the deficit compared to 6 months ago because of the earthquake, less tax revenue, some other accounting changes, for instance around leaky homes, where we've put a scheme in place. So we're adding a significant amount of debt to that overseas vulnerability. So next year we want to make sure that we're pulling that back. In the long run though, we're still on track. So the numbers are a bit worse in the short term. That's just a product of today's circumstances and some one-offs. We're headed for surplus in the government's books for 2015-16, just as we were at the budget. But more importantly, we're getting the blocks in place for better economic performance, you know, 5 to 7 years out. Higher savings, investment in infrastructure, getting the public sector more efficient, providing more services for less, a very good tax regime we've now got in place. So we're pretty confident that as we, you know, all get through this pretty difficult recovery, we've got the platform for lifting incomes, because in the long run that's what's going to give people a feeling that they've got a stake in this economy, it's worth investing in it and staying here.